Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Welcome back, friends. Welcome back to another video lecture by Kami Microbiologist. Today in this video lecture we are going to talk about xylosylicin targetol 4 agar medium or XLT4 agar medium. In the previous videos lecture we talked about different culture media, and we talked about that what is actually culture media. If you missed this video lecture, so go back to my channel and watch it. Now, what is XLT4 media? Let's talk about it. Stocks, what is XLT4 media? It is actually a highly selective media. Highly selective media means this media is specially used for the identification of Salmonella species like Salmonella gillnerum, Salmonella typhurium, Salmonella polurum. These types of the Salmonella species can easily grow on this media. Some of them are fermented, sugar fermented, some of them are non-sugar fermented. We will talk in this video later. Okay. So it is used for the isolation of Salmonella, especially from environmental food sample or clinical sample. This media was first discovered by a scientist named Miller and Tate. Let's talk about the composition of this media. This media contains peptone 1.6 gram for 1 liter. This media contains yeast extract 3 gram for 1 liter, L-lysine 5 gram for 1 liter, xylose, which is the sugar content, 3 gram for 1 liter, lactose and sucrose 7.5 gram for 1 liter, agar 15 gram for 1 liter, ferric ammonium citrate 0.8 gram for 1 liter, sodium thiosulfate 6.8 gram for 1 liter, sodium chloride 5 gram for 1 liter, and at the end we need distilled water to mix all these ingredients in 1 liter. Now let's talk about the principle of this media, that how this media, the ingredient which is present in this media, what are the function of this ingredient. As we already talked that these two ingredients like peptone and yeast extract specially used to give energy to the bacteria, and due to this way the bacteria can easily grow and divide it up. So it is possible by the yeast and peptone. Actually these two ingredients provided nutrients and some cofactor. Moreover, it also providing nitrogen compounds. Okay, now then we have xylose, lactose, sucrose, which is what, which are the carbohydrates. So remember guys, the fermentation of these carbohydrates as well as the decarboxylation of lysine, means when the carbon atom is removed, then what happen, acid is produced, which we called it H2S. This acid will change the phenol red indicator, and thus the pH value will drop, which can be detected by anions, which we call it ferric coin. Okay, and all these characteristics actually possible by a bacteria which we call it Salmonella species. Then we have sodium thiosulfate. Now sodium thiosulfate is actually inorganic sulfur, which is also needed for the DNA and RNA when it is become strong. So it is possible by this way. We have sodium chloride, again this is used for the osmotic balance, means the ingredient which is present outside the cell, so cell will easily uptake this ingredient, and the waste material which is present inside the cell will be released out, so it is possible by the NaCl. Then we have agar, which can, you know, acting as a solidifying agent and provide a stable surface due to which the bacterial colony will be easily grow. We have distilled water, which is specially used to mix all the ingredient. Then we have a supplement like Targetol 4. This supplement is present in a liquid form, and it is needed 4.6 ml, okay, in 1 liter. So this supplement is actually specially used to inhibit the growth of non-Salmonella species. Non-Salmonella species will be gram negative except Salmonella and other gram positive bacteria as well. So only Salmonella bacteria can grow on this media. This is due to this supplement. Then how we can prepare this media? So again in this case what we will do, first of all we will weight 59 gram of the media powder using weight balance machine, and will mix it into 1 liter. After that we will add 4.6 ml supplement in this in this 1 liter. After that we will heat mix it and boil it. Once the media is boiled for a while, so then we will stop the hot plate. Now after that we will cool down it and then pour it into petri plate, sterilized petri plate. Now remember guys, in this case we will not autoclave this media. Remember guys, if we autoclave this media, so the supplement or the other material will be disturbed, and this media is especially used for salmonella. So if we autoclave it, so other type of the bacteria can also be grow. So do not autoclave this media. Okay, just boil it and after that pour it into petri plate and use it. Now once the media gets solidified, so then streak your sample which you collected and incubate the plate at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hour inside the incubator machine. After 24 hour incubation, then examine the colony morphology. Then what type of the result of the salmonella bacteria we get on this media? Remember guys, if we talked about the salmonella, so we have many species of the salmonella. So these are the most important species which I write here: Salmonella gallinarum, Typhoidea, Pullularia, Enteritida. So Salmonella typhoidea will show yellow to red colony with black center. Now this second picture showing the Salmonella typhoidea colony. Salmonella enteritida show reddish colony. So as you can see, Salmonella gallinarum and Typhoidea, enteritida have the same. A little bit changes if we talked about. So in this case, in case of the Salmonella enteritida, a little bit blackish center will be present, which is not detected in case of the Salmonella gallinarum. Then we have Salmonella pullularia, which have colorless yellowish colony. This means that Salmonella pullularia is a non-lactose fermenter, and the remaining three are the fermenter. Some of them are xylose, some of them are lactose. So this is all about the XLT4 media. I hope you guys get idea about that. Thanks for watching.